Hi guys, in this video I'm going to show you how you can add neon text to your website. It's extremely easy to do, so don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button and let's get into the video. Okay, to add our neon text into Elementor, the first thing we need to do is add a new section, and I'm going to select three columns. In the center column, I'm going to drag in a heading widget. And in the heading widget, I'm going to type in on the left hand side, open 24 hours. Once I've finished typing in the text, I'm going to center align it on our page. Now I'm going to go up to the advanced tab on the left hand side, and then I'm going to scroll down to the bottom to custom CSS. And I'm going to paste in our custom CSS code. You do need Elementor Pro to add CSS code to your page. If you haven't got Elementor Pro, there is a link in the top of the description. With our code added, we're now going to go back into the style tab on the top left hand side and choose a color for our text. You might be wondering why our text hasn't got our glow yet, and that's because I haven't added our CSS class name. I will add that in a few minutes. Until then, we're going to click on style in the top left hand side and choose the color picker. Now, if you think of a real neon sign, a lot of the color comes from the reflective glow on the background. And a lot of the text almost appears white. And this is the effect we're going to add now. Once you've chosen your color, I'm going to stick with the red. You're going to want to move the ball up into the color palette and select a dark version of the overall color. Then you're going to need to copy that hex color. Once you've done that, go into the advanced tab in the top left hand side and select your custom CSS at the bottom of the list. Now if you scroll to the bottom of the code, you can see a list of hex colors, and this is where we start building up the color of our text. The lower you are down the list, the darker your color should be, and this is because you're further away from the light source. With that being said, we're going to replace the two existing colors in our code, so we're going to have to highlight them on both lines and paste in our color. Once that's done, we're going to go back into the style tab in the top left hand side and choose the color picker again. Now we're going to choose a lighter color of our text that we're going to be using back in our code. We've already changed the bottom two, so now we're going to select and paste in our color for the next three lines. You can fade this out even more by changing each color on each line, making it lighter as you get to the top of the list. Once that's done, we're going to go back into the style tab in the top left hand side. We're going to choose our color picker and we're going to make it as bright as we can this time and copy and paste that code again. Now we're going to go back into our code and paste in our color in the next two lines closer to the top of the list. You should have one line remaining that you haven't changed, so we're going to go back into the color picker this time and we're going to add more white to the color. And this is because it's closer to our text. Copy and paste this color into the last line of our code. Now we're going to go back into the style tab for the last time and choose a pinky color for our text. All that's left to do is go into the advanced tab and add our CSS class name. As soon as you've finished typing it in, it will automatically update. Now you can preview your page by clicking on the preview button next to the update button on the left hand side. So there you have it, it's extremely easy to add a neon effect to your text. If you want to change the size of your text, all you need to do is go back into Elementor, click on style, typography, and then use that to change the size of your text. You can add background images to your sections that make your text appear that it's on a wall. Remember, you do need Elementor Pro to add custom CSS to your page. If you haven't got Elementor Pro, there is a link at the top of the description. It is an affiliate link, it doesn't cost you any more to use, but it does give me a very small percentage of Elementor's profits if you choose to sign up. If you have found this video useful, please do hit that like and subscribe button. And if you've got any questions, come and hit me up in the comments box below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.